My very first job was as a ticket agent at the Continental Trailways Bus Depot in Victoria, Texas, which is halfway between Houston and Corpus Christi on the Texas Gulf Coast. I had that job, worked 8 hours a day or at night, afternoon and night, while I was going to a little junior college in Victoria, Texas. As a result of that, it was also the first time I was paid money to speak into a microphone. And I can prove it, that I can still do it. May I have your attention, please? This is your last call for Continental Trailways, 8:10 p.m. Silversides air conditioned throughliner to Houston. Now leaving from lane 1 for Inez, Edna, Canada, Louise, El Campo, Pierce, Wharton, Hungerford, Kenneth, and Beasley, Rosenberg, Richmond, Sugarland, Stafford, Missouri City, and Houston. All aboard! Don't forget your baggage, please. And for the record, Charlie Rose can't do that. After I graduated from college, I went to the University of Missouri Journalism School, and then I was an infantry officer in the Marine Corps for 3 years, running up and down hills. One of the most important experiences I had, I learned to be dependent on others and learned what it was like to have people dependent on me. It changed my life. I was a punk kid who could call buses, but that was about it. And I came out as a punk kid, but who could do a lot more than just call buses. And it is certainly shaped me as an individual. And then I went, after I got out of the Marine Corps, I was a newspaper reporter in Dallas, Texas, I started writing obits and doing the weather. And was a newspaper man for 10 years, was city editor of the afternoon newspaper in Dallas when I wrote my first novel. And it was made into a movie and made $45,000 on the movie. My wife and I I've always wanted to write full time, and Kate was, my wife's also a writer. We'll just do that. And then lo and behold, I was asked to do an experimental news program in Dallas for the local public television station. And before I knew it, I was in public television, and I've been there ever since. The advice to aspiring novelists is only one piece of advice. Keep bottom on chair. You can have great ideas, you can have great characters, you can have great stories you want to tell, but if you don't write, you're not a writer. All you are is a talker about writing. And you can't edit anything, you can't get anything published, nobody's going to read it if you don't write it. And the only thing to remember about journalism is just cover and write and present every story you do as if it were about you, and you'll be fine. The thing I think that news producers must keep in mind, and those who manage and lead news producers, is that in the first instance there must be news. That there are now a lot of avenues open for people to comment on the news, to react to the news on the internet, on shout shows on radio, and on cable television and other wonderful places. That's terrific. To have the commentary and to have the disputes and the discussions and the shouting even. I don't, that doesn't give me a problem. But they have to have something to shout about. They have to know what happened before they can move to that second phase, to the reaction phase. And those of us who are in the reporting business need to keep that in mind, because we have that all to ourselves. And there's an increasing need, there's evidence that there is an increasing need and want for people to have that first take on the news before they go to the second, and that's our job. Those are those people who produce the news and report the news for a living must keep that in mind. Not try to go over the line, not try to join the crowd and be entertaining. You want to be entertained? Go to the circus. You know, don't watch the news hour. Don't watch a news program. We're not there to make you cry or make you laugh or any of that. The news may make you laugh, the news may make you cry, but that's not our purpose. And that's what people should keep in mind in this line of work.